What's going on YouTube? My name is Skill37. In today's video, I'm going to be discussing about the whole new thing on Facebook and the Xbox 3, you know, the 360 faggots bitching and complaining, calling the Sony Warriors, the Spartans, you know, us real gamers, hypocrites, because we seem to be taking these, you know, so-called cheap shots at the Xbox One for being a multimedia functioning cable box that rewards you for watching sports. You know, I'm just gonna say, I remember when the PS3 came out, and Sony really did boast about it being more than just a console. Sony did indeed boast about how it was more than just a gaming machine. They advertised to be a multi-functioning console capable of being more than just a video game machine in your living room. And the thing is, we Sony Warriors never denied that. We thought it was pretty cool, but Sony never denied the fact that the machine was indeed a console. Sony never denied the fact that the machine was indeed meant for gaming. It was just, they wanted to try something different. They wanted to introduce a console that did more than just game. And when the PS3 first came out, it had quite a few multimedia functions in terms of being a central hub. The PS3 was capable of bringing you outstanding quality for your Blu-rays. Over time, it became the best Netflix player possible, being able to, you know, produce the best Netflix experience with the pure Super HD 1080 pixels. You know, if you were a music buff and if you knew how to hardwire shit, the PS3 was could have been, if you hooked it up, a pure entertainment system. You didn't actually need to go out and buy no fucking, you know, Super Stereo or bullshit like that. But Sony never denied that the machine was still a console. Okay, since day one. So I'm really finding it confusing that the Xbox 360 butthurt fangirls are really like calling us hypocrites and shit, talking about the Xbox One plays games too. See, the problem we have with the Xbox One is this, okay? And you know what? Let's be realistic here. E3 is still around the corner. You know, Microsoft still has one more chance to redeem itself. If Microsoft does not redeem itself at E3, then it's pretty much done. It's pretty much done. You see, Sony learned. Okay, let's be realistic. When some PS3 first came out, it lacked a lot of functions necessary for it to be a very enjoyable console experience. But see, unlike other developers, Nintendo, Sony picked up real quick. It wasn't the end of the generation. It wasn't even the middle of the generation. It was a few years after the release of the PS3 that Sony realized that its advertising scheme and ploys and plans, you need to be reworked. They realized that maybe this just was not the time to boast about the PS3 capabilities in terms of it being a multimedia functioning device. Because at the end of the day, and I'm being very fucking serious right now, if you buy a console to do anything other than gaming as the main reason you bought that console, you're stupid as fuck. Who buys an Xbox or a PS3 to do something first before gaming? Who does that? Who actually said, I want to buy this machine to watch sports? That's the problem we have with the Xbox One. The Xbox One is being advertised at the very moment not as a video game console. It's not. I don't even think it's a console. They're not advertising it to be a video game console. See, Sony learned. As the years progressed with the PS3, Sony flipped the script and made it purely everything they released about all the big patches was all gaming based. And the best part about the PS3 is that even though it was released and stated that it was not really meant to be just a gaming console, Sony learns really quickly that its fan base is pretty fucking hardcore, and we are very verbal and we talk a lot of shit, and every patch introduced features we wanted. Now, granted, we never got cross-game chat. It was for reasons such as the PS3 having very low memory, which really fucked up the majority of the things we couldn't have on the PS3. Sony learned. And with the PlayStation 4, you see, we are well aware. The Sony fanboys, we, the Sony Warriors, we are well aware that the PlayStation 4 is a very powerful multimedia functioning machine. The thing is, we don't need to talk about it. Sony knows that they do not need to talk about the capabilities of the PlayStation 4 outside of gaming, because we already know what it can do. It's 2013. We're going into 2014. We as gamers and basically consumers, we don't need to be told that the PlayStation 4 can do everything the PS3 can do and better. we have PS3. We can see what the PS3 could already do with the Sony Music Service and the Netflix and the Hulu. So why talk about things that we already know exist? I don't need to be told that my PS4 is capable of letting me watch sports. All we want to hear is gaming, and Sony picked up on that real quick. And everything Sony is talking about when it comes to the PS4 is strictly fucking gaming. That's why the Sony fanboys, the warriors, we're so proud of ourselves. We are so verbal that the fucking top executives, the people that represent Sony, even said it themselves on Twitter. Remember in my last video? Had people at Sony talk about, we love our fan base. They talk hella shit. We love that. That's crazy. That we talk hella shit and we get what we want. We're verbal. We're not like the Microsoft Xbox 360 fanboys. They just take it up the ass. They just get what's given to them. No, we're very verbal. Let's be realistic here. When it comes to the DRM campaign, digital rights management, we might lose. We might lose. Because at the end of the day, it's not really, believe it or not, Sony who gets to make the decision. It's the game developers. It really is their decision. You got to look at it from their perspective. They want to get money too. They want to get their bank. And the whole digital rights management campaign is not really against the gamers. It's more or less against, how can I put it, GameStop selling used games. Developers hate it when, you know, people like GameStop sell a game, they don't get money for the game. Developers, they don't want you to not play their game, but they want to be compensated in one shape, way, or form. And I understand that. Sony might lose this battle because, thinking from a developer's point of view, you're going to develop two games. A game on the Xbox One that needs to be recoded, rewritten, to be played on a second machine. Then they got to make a PS4 version that doesn't do all that. So it's as if they're creating two different games of the same game. So Sony might actually lose this one, but Sony has acknowledged the fact that we, the Sony Warriors, talk a lot of shit, and they're very proud of us. I was watching a ReviewTech USA. Oh, look, congratulations, ReviewTech USA. Your channel, like, exploded. Like, you're fucking great. I love your channel, dude. You talk very, you know, you're very intellectual when it comes to shit like this. Before, your channel was like this. Now your channel's, like, all the way up here. Like, you totally just, like, shitted on mine. Oh, shit. I went on your channel. I was like, wow. What happened? Good shit. So, let's be realistic here. We might lose the DRM campaign. And I might, you know, just we might have to just come to terms and accept that because not really Sony's 100% control, but we stepped up, we tried. And if we do win, then holy shit, that's fucking awesome. But I just want to talk about a couple of things. When the PS3 first came out and as the years of the PS3 progressed, did you not notice how humble Sony was? I know something about that. Sony never seemed to poke their chest out like Microsoft. Microsoft always poked their chest out. Why? Because Microsoft knew that last generation early on belonged to them. And I admit it. They had the software. They were ready. They were ready to take risks with Xbox Live. And they were successful. As years progressed, Sony slowly caught up. And then shit on Xbox. Hey, but it took the whole fucking generation to do it, which kind of sucks, you know. But look how the tides have turned. Microsoft is on some real bitch shit, disabling comments on the Xbox One YouTube channel because they're very upset that the journalists and the fan base are talking hella shit. Maybe, just maybe, when the Xbox One was revealed, their strategist, their team that does the whole marketing scheme kind of fucked up with the whole TV sports thing. Maybe the Xbox One does a lot more than we give it credit for. But guess what? It doesn't matter what your machine can do at the end of the day. It's all about word of mouth and proper advertisement. And right now, due to in a very bad advertisement, word of mouth is spreading that the Xbox One sucks fucking dick. And due to proper advertisement and extreme word of mouth, the Sony PlayStation 4 is getting stupidly amazing fucking praise. Stupid amazing praise. Devs and big cheeses of all different corporations are praising the PS4. This guy, I got these names written down because I can't read fucking Japanese. Kazu Harai, the big cheese of Sony, has the biggest smile on his fucking face right now. Okay, Yoshida. He's just blatantly talking shit on Twitter. That's the amount of confidence they have. Mark Cerny has been defending the PlayStation 4 from journalists talking shit that it might be obsolete in a few years. No. That's how, this is the confidence level. The tides have turned. Now Sony's poking its chest because Sony knows. Sony knows. They may have not had their, you know, two steps ahead of the game last generation and they played catch up. But this is Sony. You people honestly think that Sony loses billions of dollars in a PS3 that they're going broke? Do you realize that billions of dollars is not much to corporations like Microsoft and Sony? You read these articles on N4G and bullshit. Like, I like N4G. Sometimes you can find a reliable article on N4G, but lots of people do bullshit articles. $1 billion, as much as it sounds, is not a lot of money to corporations like Microsoft and Sony. Sony is not just a video game, you know, business. They do lots of other things. They can indeed sacrifice billions of dollars to make mistakes. And that's basically what happened with PS3. And through the fuck-ups with the PS3 and it being worked out to become a much better home entertainment machine, all that, with better marketing, Mark Cerny, of course, are bringing to the PlayStation 4. That's why Microsoft is shitting their fucking boots right now. This is why their marketing, their campaigning, their marketing planning all sucks. Because they thought they could rely on the Xbox 360 to carry them into the Xbox One. You have a stupid fucking name, Xbox One. You have horrible advertisement. And you know, this is the internet. Word of mouth is the strongest form of advertisement. Like I said, bad advertisement, bad word of mouth, you're already lost. Sony, PlayStation 4, literally the complete opposite of last generation. Poking their chest out. They know they got this in the bag. And Nintendo, what the fuck? What happened? I mean, shit. I don't like you guys, but at least I, the gamer, I had respect for Nintendo. I had respect. Like, you guys seemed to know what you were doing years ago. Now it's just like, you fucked up. You guys suck. You might not even be at E3. What the fuck? But yeah, that's it for today's video. I had to talk a little shit. Bring the Xbox. You know, sometimes the Xbox 360 people, I feel their ego skyrocketing a bit, and then I just gotta come in, being the Sony warrior I am, and bring them back the fuck down where they belong. Remember that shit. Trade for life, bitches.